Good morning, everybody. I have a couple announcements for you. The first one is that we are still collecting backpack supplies, and if you, our box is getting full, but if you still have more, we have a couple more weeks until you have two more Sundays after today to bring in your backpack school supplies if you would like to bring that. Also, if you are somebody who usually goes to the community free meal that is put together by the Delco Food Project, today, because it is going to be so warm, they are doing to-go meal boxes, and so you're welcome to come between 4:30 and 5:30 and come over to Buchter Hall, to the social hall, and you can get a meal, but then you could just go home versus, so there's still a free meal tonight, just not a meal together. Are there any prayer requests, or does anybody have a God moment that they would like to share? Well, if there are none, please stand as you are comfortable for our confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, whose steadfast love endures forever. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not followed your path, but have chosen our own way. Instead of putting others before ourselves, we long to take the best seats at the table. When met by those in need, we have too often passed by on the other side. Set us again on the path of life. Save us from ourselves and free us to love our neighbors. May you hear this good news. God does not deal with us according to our sins, but delights in granting pardon and mercy. And so it is in the name of Jesus Christ that your sins are forgiven. You are free to love as God loves. Our gathering hymn today is I Love to Tell the Story.
Satisfies my longings as love.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. And for this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious God. And let us pray our prayer of the day. Almighty and ever-living God, you are always more ready to hear than we are to pray. And you gladly give more than we either desire or deserve. Pour upon us your abundant mercy. Forgive us those things that weigh on our conscience, and give us those good things that come only through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. You may be seated for our readings.
Good morning. The first reading is from Genesis chapter 18, verses 20 through 32. Then the Lord said, "How great is the outcry against Sodom and Gomorrah, and how very grave their sin. I must go down and see whether they have done altogether according to the outcry that has come to me. And if not, I will know." So the men turned from there and went toward Sodom, while Abraham remained standing before the Lord. Then Abraham came near and said, "Will you indeed sweep away the righteous with the wicked? Suppose there are 50 righteous within the city. Will you then sweep away the place and not forgive it for the 50 50 righteous who are in it? Far be it from you to do such a thing. To say the righteous with the wicked, to slay the righteous with the wicked, so that the righteous have fare as the wicked. Far be that that from you. Shall not the judge of the earth do what is said?" I'm sorry, I'm reading this. And the Lord said, "If I find Sodom," I've lost my place. Abraham said, "Let me take it upon myself to speak to the Lord. I who am but dust and ashes. Suppose 5 of the 50 righteous are lacking. Will you destroy the whole city for the lack of 5? And he said, "I will not destroy if I find 45 there." Again he spoke to him, "Suppose 40 are found there." He answered, "For the sake of the 40, I will not do it." Then he said, "Oh, do let the Lord be angry if I speak. Suppose 30 are found there." He answered, "I will not do it. If there, he answered, "For the sake of the 20, I will not destroy it." Then he said, "Oh, do not let the Lord be angry if I speak just once more. Suppose there are 10 found there." He answered, "For the sake of 10, I will not destroy it." This is the word of the Lord. The second reading is from Colossians chapter 2, verses 6 through 19. "As you therefore have received Christ Jesus the Lord, continue to live your lives in him, rooted and built up in him and established in the faith, just as you were taught, abounding in thanksgiving. See to it that no one takes you captive through philosophy and empty deceit, according to human tradition, according to the elemental spirits of the universe, and not according to Christ. For in him the whole fullness of deity dwells bodily, and you have come to fullness in him, who is in the head of every ruler and authority. In him also you were circumcised with a spiritual circumcision by putting off the body of the flesh and the circumcision of Christ. When you were buried with him in baptism, you were also raised with him through faith in the power of God, who raised him from the dead. And when you were dead in trespasses and the uncircumcision of your flesh, God made you alive together with him when he forgave us all our trespasses, erasing the record that stood against us with its legal demands. He set this aside, nailing it to the cross. He disarmed the rulers and authorities and made a public example of them, triumphing over them in it. Therefore, do not let anyone condemn you in matters of food and drink, or of observing festivals, new moons, or Sabbaths. There are only a shadow of what is to come, but the substance dwelling on visions, puffed up without cause by a human way of thinking, and not holding fast to the head, from whom the whole body, nourished and held together by its ligaments and sinews, grows with a growth that is from God. This is the word of the Lord.
Stand as you are comfortable for our gospel reading. The Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus was praying in a certain place, and after he had finished, one of his disciples said to him, "Lord, teach us to pray, as John taught his disciples." So he said to them, "When you pray, say, Father, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, for we ourselves forgive everyone indebted to us, and do not bring us to the time of trial." And he said to them, "Suppose one of you has a friend, and you go to him at midnight and say to him, 'Friend, lend me 3 loaves of bread, for a friend of mine has arrived, and I have nothing to set before him.' And he answers from within, 'Do not bother me. The door has already been locked, and my children are with me in bed. I cannot give up and give you anything.' I tell you, even though he will not get up and give him anything because he is his friend, at least because of his persistence, he will get up and give him whatever he needs. So I say to you, ask, and it will be given. You search, and you will find. Knock, and the door will be opened for you. For everyone who asks receives, and everyone who searches finds, and for everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. Is there anyone among you who, if a child asks for a fish, will give a snake instead of a fish? Or if the child asks for an egg, will give a scorpion? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him?" The Gospel of our Lord. You may be seated. Lord, teach us to pray, right? These are the words of the disciples. They had seen John talking to his disciples, teaching them how to pray. Jesus' disciples have just seen Jesus praying at a certain spot. And so they say, Jesus, teach us to pray. One of the first prayers that I remember learning and kind of memorizing, one could say, is the table prayer, Come, Lord Jesus, be our guest. Let these gifts to us be blessed. Amen. The other one that I think about is one that is sometimes said before going to bed. Now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. If I die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take. Words and the way that prayers are said have changed over the years. I remember that prayer of the Now I Lay Me Down to Sleep, that version. I was given this teddy bear by a family, and it says this one.
Now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. Your love be with me through the night, and wake me with the morning light. Amen.
Right? So instead of saying, I pray the Lord my soul to take, right, if I die before I wake, this little teddy bear says, God's love, you be with me through the night and wake me with the morning light. The words may change, but the meaning is somewhat the same. It is also with the Lord's Prayer. Here in Luke, we hear one version of the Lord's Prayer. In Matthew's Gospel, there is another. And then also, there are even a couple others that we know today. If you would like, you can go into your hymnal, and on page 112, there is the Lord's Prayer that we say, right, that has trespasses. But there's also more of a contemporary version that says, forgive us our sins. And then there's also even a sung version, right? Like the contemporary service does. And so all of these words are pretty much very similar, but they change a little bit, right? We begin by saying, Our Father who art in heaven. Here in saying that, we, like Jesus, are drawing ourselves into an intimate relationship with God. The word that Jesus says when he says Father, he is saying Abba, Father, Parent. You are holy, right? We come to say that God's name is holy. We ask God's kingdom to come, to God's kingdom to be here on earth, and that God's will be done. These first three petitions are all about God. Which brings us to the next four petitions, which is about you and me. We ask God to give us our daily bread. We ask God to forgive us, to save us from temptation, and to deliver us from evil. Have you ever thought about what it means to ask God to give us our daily bread? Do you think that when you are praying this for yourself, are you saying, all right, God, give me this nice loaf of bread? Or are you thinking more in a broader sense of, God, give me the things that I need to sustain me? In Martin Luther, in his Small Catechism, he defines this when he says, what is this? In fact, God gives daily bread without our prayer, even to all evil people. But we ask this prayer that God causes us to recognize what our daily bread is and to receive it with thanksgiving. And so he specifically says, what does daily bread mean? He says, everything included in the necessities and nourishment for our bodies, such as food, drink, clothing, shoes, house, farm, fields, livestock, money, property, an upright spouse, upright children, upright members of the household, upright and faithful rulers, good government, good weather, peace, health, decency, honor, good friends, faithful neighbors, and the like. When we ask God for daily bread, it is more than just saying, God, just feed me. Feed me with physical food, but it is also feed me spiritually, right? Or give me good weather, right? How many of you pray for the weather? In my first call, I don't know how many times, especially on internship, I was praying for rain in an agricultural area, right? That was probably the first time I'd ever encountered somebody saying in their prayer request, pray for rain, Pastor, or pray that we don't get any more rain, right? That may be here. I remember a few years last year when we had all of the flooding, right? But that is a part of what we are asking when we say, give us our daily bread. It is also when we ask God to forgive us, right? As we forgive those. Sometimes forgiving others is hard. Sometimes forgiving yourself can also be hard. But also asking God for forgiveness can also be somewhat of a hard thing. But God is there, forgiving you and listening to your prayers. Which brings me to kind of the end where it says, deliver us from evil. Or in the version in Luke, it says, save us from our time of trial. Save us from temptation, things that are out there causing us to stray. For that petition, Luther says, it is true that God tempts no one, but we ask in this prayer that God would preserve and keep us so that the devil, the world, and our flesh may not deceive us or mislead us into false belief, despair, and other great and shameful sins, and that although we may be attacked by them, we may finally prevail and gain the victory. The final thing that we have here that is not in the scriptures is the conclusion, right? We end our prayer by saying, for thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours forever and ever. Amen. I invite you to go home to your Bibles at home and see if there is a little asterisk in your Bibles that have a little line that says, in some translations, in some older texts, there is included this line, the conclusion. And so that's why we say that, for thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Right? Amen. Yes, yes, may it be so. Prayer is all around us. We have this prayer that we have know from memory, but there's also extemporaneous prayer where you are filled with the Holy Spirit and you are sharing kind of whatever is coming to your mind. One way for me that I try and remember different prayers is the five-finger prayer. You start with your thumb. You pray for those who are closest to you, your family, your friends. Your pointer finger is that one who points, so you're remembering, you're praying for those who are teachers, those people who guide you in life. The tallest one, your middle finger, you are praying for different leaders. Your ring finger is kind of the weakest of your fingers, right? So it's kind of that one. So you are praying for the weak and all of those in need. And the final one, the little pinky, the little one, you are praying for yourself. You are praying for yourself and your needs. And when we do, whether we speak these prayers aloud, whether we use words or not, whether we just sigh, that is a prayer. And so we may ask God to teach us to pray. But dear friends, you know how to pray. Prayer is conversation with God. God hears and answers your prayers. The answer may be no, or not yet, or yes. But God hears your prayers. Amen. And if you would like your own small catechism to kind of learn more about what Luther has said about different parts of the Lord's Prayer, the Ten Commandments, the creeds, I have a few out on the welcome table that you are welcome to take. Also, if you have a hymnal at home, the small catechism is at the very end of your hymnal. Our hymn of the day will be, What a Friend We Have in Jesus.
I'm gonna go
Trusting in God's extraordinary love, let us come near to the Holy One in prayer. Rooted and built up in Christ, we pray for the church. Embolden church leaders to take risks for the sake of the gospel, and to equip the baptized to proclaim your extravagant love for the whole world. Merciful God, rejoicing in the works of your hands, we pray for the natural world. Make rivers and lakes, oceans and all waterways sparkle with your radiance. Protect water sources and strengthen those who defend them. Merciful God, interceding on behalf of the vulnerable, we pray for the people of the world. Inspire all rulers and governing authorities with your justice. Guide the work of legislators and public officials that they advocate for the well-being of those they serve. Merciful God, and persistent in prayer, we pray for our neighbors in need. To all who have hunger, give daily bread. To all who have bread, give hunger for justice. Open us to the cries of those who suffer. And today we especially pray for those we name aloud or silently in our hearts. Merciful God, abounding in thanksgiving, we pray for this congregation. Bless the prayer and fellowship ministries in this place. Call us together in times of praise and blessing, trouble and sorrow, in your holy name. Merciful God, buried with Christ in baptism and raised with him in new life, we give thanks for your saints who rest in your eternal presence. And join our voices with theirs as we sing of your great glory. Merciful God, and receive the prayers of your children, merciful God, and hold us forever in your steadfast love through Jesus Christ, our holy wisdom. May the peace of Christ be with you always. I invite you to share a sign of that peace with those gathered here today. Peace be with you. I invite you to be seated as we will collect our offering. Stand as you are comfortable. And let us give thanks for all of the offerings that have come in here and also online. God of abundance, you have set before us a plentiful harvest. As we feast on your goodness, strengthen us to labor in your field and equip us to bear fruit for the good of all. In the name of Jesus, amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and at all places give thanks and praise to you, almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, and who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened us to the way of everlasting life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and joyfully proclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. And again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to all to drink, saying, This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me. And Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The table is ready. All are welcome. This is God's table, and God makes no restrictions. You may be seated, and we are going to hear Mason sing a version of the Lamb of God, and as we do, you are invited to prepare your elements, and we will commune all together after.
My Jesus Christ, my Lord.
Taking your bread, hear these words, the body of Christ given for you. And taking your cup, hear these words, the blood of Christ shed for you. Stand as you are comfortable for our blessing after communion. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and give you peace. Amen. And let us pray. Life-giving God, through this meal you have bandaged our wounds and fed us with your mercy. Now send us forth to live for others, both friend and stranger, that all may come to know your love. This we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. May the God of peace, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you, comfort you, and show you the path of life this day and always. Our final hymn today is How Great Thou Art.
Thank you.
May you go in peace, knowing how to pray and loving your neighbor.